Hello, today we are going to be talking about simplifying fractions. When we're simplifying fractions, what we're really doing is finding equivalent fractions that have the same value, but it has the fewest number of pieces and the pieces are larger. So if we take a look at something like this fraction here, this represents the fraction 4/6, right? So we have 4 pieces shaded and 6 pieces total. Well, if we're simplifying 4/6, again, we're trying to make the fewest number of pieces that are larger. So what we're really going to do is we're going to combine some of these pieces so that we can make things where everything is the same size and we're taking into account what's shaded. So I could try and combine these 3 pieces and these 3 pieces and make halves. But what happens when I do that is this is all shaded, but only part of this is shaded. So that won't work. I can, however, combine and say that, all right, here I have a group of two, here I have a group of two, and here I have a group of two. So now if I kind of remake that to show those pieces, I'm seeing that now I have 3 pieces. And if I still say the same value, I have two of them shaded. So that is the fraction 2/3. So this is showing that 4/6 is equivalent to 2/3. And so the way I mathematically kind of do that is each of these pieces, they're being combined. That's what's making them have fewer pieces. So if I am combining these, I'm taking every 2 pieces and combining them into one. So if I kind of take and say that I'm dividing my numerator, the number of counted pieces, I'm combining every two into one, I'm dividing that by two. And so my total number of pieces, again, every 2 pieces, I'm combining into one. So that would be saying that 4/6. If I take the numerator and divide it by two, and I take the denominator and divide it by two, that is showing me an equivalent fraction of 2/3. Okay, so now we're going to kind of talk about how to do that for any fraction. So, for example, if I have the fraction 6/18, and I want to find an equivalent fraction that is simplified, meaning I have fewer number of pieces, I really need to think about the factors of 6 and the factors of 18. So if I think about the factors of 6 and the factors of 18, well, my factors of 6, of course, are 1 and 6, and also 2 and 3. My factors of 18 are 1 and 18, 2 and 9, 3 and 6. Okay, so here are my factors. And I really, so the first thing we did was we found the factors of both my numerator and my denominator. Okay. Now, what I'm going to look and see is that when I look at these factors, what do they have in common? So I want to see what factors they have in common. And I notice, of course, they have one in common, they have two, they have three, and they have six. So that's really a lot of factors that they have in common. But I really need to look for the greatest common factor. So when I'm looking at my lists of factors, which one is the biggest that they have in common? That's the one I really want to look at. So here I have a factor of 6, and here I have a factor of 6. So those are my greatest factors that they have in common. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide
my numerator by 6 and my denominator by 6. Okay, so I'm going to divide and that is my greatest common factor. I'm going to divide them both by the greatest common factor. So 6 divided by 6, that's saying that for every 6 pieces, I'm combining them into 1. That equals 1. And 18 divided by 6, the total number of pieces, every 6 pieces now becomes 1. And so that is 3. So this is showing that 6 18ths equals 1 third. And if I actually look at my factors and I do it by pairs, if I divide 6 by 6, it's the factor pair. And if I divide 18 by 6, what I get is my factor pair. So that's an example. Let's do one more together, and then I'm going to have you guys try one. So let's say we have 9 24ths. Okay, again, the first thing we want to do is find the factors of both our numerator and our denominator. So 9 and 24. So go ahead, pause the video, and find your factors of 9 and 24. All right, so for 9, we have 1 and 9 and 3 and 3. For 24, there's a lot more factors. We have 1 and 24, 2 and 12, 3 and 8, and 4 and 6. Okay, so now looking at my two lists, what is the greatest factor they both have in common? Well, the only factors I see are 1 and 3. So if I look at those, I have that is my greatest common factor, okay? Which means I'm going to take and I'm going to divide, combine every 3 pieces into 1 piece. So 9 divided by 3, again, I could use my factor pairs there, is 3. So I'm going to have 3 pieces shaded, and I'm going to have 24 divided by 3, which is 8. I'm going to have 8 pieces total. So this is an equivalent fraction. These are equivalent fractions, and this is my simplified fraction. All right, so I would like you to go ahead and try to find the simplified fraction for 5 twelfths and for 10 twelfths. Once you find that, continue the video and we'll take a look at doing it together. All right, so for 5 twelfths, we found all the factor pairs, 1 and 5, and then here are my factor pairs for 12. Well, when I'm looking at this, I don't have any factors other than 1 that they have in common. So what does that mean? Well, that actually means that this is simplified. I cannot combine any pieces. So really, 5 twelfths is our simplified fraction. All right, well, now let's take a look at what we have for 10 twelfths. All right, for 10 twelfths, we found our factors, and the greatest factor they have in common is 2. So that means that for every 2 pieces, I'm going to combine and make it 1. So we're going to divide our numerator and our denominator by 2. So 10 divided by 2 is 5. And 12 divided by 2 is 6. And again, if you look at your factor pairs, that can help you out in knowing what your new fraction is. So that is simplifying fractions. If you have any questions, please be sure to let me know. And please also make sure that you have all of your notes written in your notebook. And I'll see you in math class.